Hello Homo sapiens, hope you are doing good. If not, no worries, because I'm back with an interesting video. In our last two videos, we had a discussion over formation of oceans, Bowen's reaction series, and also why oceans are denser. These concepts form a base to understand the formation of continental crust. So people who haven't watched them, I'll suggest you to do it. You are watching Fun with Geo channel. We come with interesting videos related to static and contemporary geographical events, and sometimes inspirational videos too. So without any delay, let's start our discussion to know how continents are formed by the deformation of oceans. A quick brief of formation of oceanic crust. Upwelling hot molten magma under the influence of convectional currents led to crustal thinning and crustal breakage. And finally, cooling and solidification of this outpour hot molten material led to the formation of oceanic crust. Now, at convergent plate boundary, the denser plate is undergoing subduction. This subducted plate cannot sustain extreme temperatures prevailing at greater depths. Thus, oceanic crust gets melted and this hot molten part moves towards the Earth's surface. The movement of this hot molten magma towards Earth's surface leads to crustal thinning followed by crustal breakage. Through breakpoint, molten magma erupts out and then cools and solidifies to form volcanic arc. When this volcanic arc was raised above sea level, that was the first time continental crust was formed, which is made up of granite and andesite rock. Now comes the important aspect. There is a difference between oceanic crust and continental crust. Here we can observe that continental crust is in the form of volcanic arc or a mountain peak. But when we observe oceanic crust, it is in the form of small ridges where molten material is distributed over large area. This is because ocean crust is made up of basaltic rock, whereas continental crust is made up of granite rock. Basaltic rock has less silica compared to granite rock. Silica represents viscosity of the material. Higher the silica, higher is the viscosity of the material. Viscosity means stickiness of the material. So, as basaltic rock has low silica, its flow capacity is higher. That is the reason why ocean crust is formed like small ridges. Another layman reason which can be derived by observing these figures is ocean crust is forming at divergent plate boundary, which makes accumulation of material difficult at single point, as this point is moving under the influence of underlying convection current. While in the case of continental crust, the point of eruption is static. So piling up of hot molten magma at this point results in the formation of volcanic arc. Coming back to our discussion, once the volcanic arc is formed, it undergoes denudation, which includes weathering and erosion of these volcanic arcs. So continuous erosion of the mountain tops and deposition at the foothills results in sedimentation. The entire process is taking place at convergent plate boundary. The convergence between two plates leads to squeezing and folding of these sediments, which results in the formation of folded mountains. Further, erosion of these folded mountains followed by deposition at its foothills results in the formation of plateaus and plains. And this is the flow chart of entire process. So you might have known about effects such as formation of oceans and continents before. And I hope these videos added a cause behind those effects by explaining how actually they were formed. Finally, and obviously, if you like this video, like, share and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.